Hi, my name is Helena Riedeberg, and this is my time capsule presentation. Even though I'm in 3D design, I mostly work on 2D work. I'm a graphic design major, and I'm really passionate about printmaking, so I'm used to working on flat surfaces. My main inspirations for creating artwork are abstraction, organic forms, people, and the inner thoughts and emotions that people hold. First, I want to talk about the wire project. This project involved choosing a real object and recreating it out of twisted wire. For my piece, I chose to do a human head because, of course, I love portraiture, and I thought it would turn out really cool as a wire sculpture. This project definitely took a lot of elbow grease. I spent many hours sitting in my living room twisting wire and bending it into place, but overall, the process was really cool. And sometimes the mindless twisting and bending of wire was actually pretty relaxing. This is the final product of my wire project, and honestly, I really like how it turned out. I definitely think it looks like a human head, and I love it so much that I even have it displayed on my bookshelf, so that really says something. It was definitely a hand exercise, but I hope I can work with wire again because I really enjoyed it. The cardboard project just barely takes the crown for my favorite project I've made. This project was fully abstract, which I love, and I decided to make my project based on super organic shapes, not really taking inspiration from anything in the real world. This project required a maquette, which was actually really helpful in the long run because I could take measurements from the maquette I made and then scale them up for my final piece. It was also nice to just have something to reference while making my bigger project just because it was so daunting, so I'm very happy with this. Constructing the final product was actually a lot easier than I expected. I got in the groove of cutting the cardboard, putting the tape on, and it was just mostly a repetitive process, but it wasn't as tiring as the wire project was. I did reference my maquette a lot, which was really nice, and I also used I used wall spackle to actually create texture on my piece, which I thought added a really cool detail. This is my final cardboard piece, and I love how it turned out. I did like the wiry one, but I just think this one is so cool and has so much movement, even though it appears to be such a solid object. I used light gray paint, but made the piece more interesting by adding lots of texture and using light to create shadows. The final project I did in this class was the plaster project. I did enjoy this, but it was definitely a lot more work than the other two, and that definitely shows in my final product. These were the small maquette ideas I made for this project. I actually didn't end up using any of these, but I still wanted to show them just to show what other ideas my project might have turned into. This project focused a lot on form and volume, and I was struggling finding an interesting but simple composition that I could meet the deadline with. Like I mentioned, this project involved a lot more steps than the other two. We had to make a full armature that was super sturdy so the plaster wouldn't just fall apart, and I decided to make mine out of wood, and I used a jigsaw to cut out the shapes and a circular saw to cut the wooden dowels. I covered the entire armature in chicken wire, and then I took strips of fabric and then put them into the mixed plaster like band-aids and covered my whole piece to make a base. And then I used plaster to spread across the whole project and then smoothed it all out with sandpaper. This is the final product of my plaster project, and I do like how it turned out, but I definitely see some refinement that could happen in some places. I did lay the plaster on well, but I could have definitely taken longer to sand and make the final project super smooth and seamless. I added rough texture where the two points at the top are about to meet to indicate the tension between the two pieces coming together. I think my final composition complements the idea of this project well, and I do like how it turned out. This class taught me a lot of new skills that I'm so happy I've learned, and I can't wait to apply them to future artwork. Thank you so much for listening to my presentation and viewing my work. I really hope you liked it, and if you want to see more of my work, you can check out my Instagram, Helena Ruby Riedeberg, and if you want to contact me, you can contact me at my email. Goodbye!